By now, you already know that DaVinci Resolve 18.5 can transcribe the individual clips and then automatically create captions for your whole timeline. But did you know that you can actually transcribe an entire sequence with just a click? That way you're transcribing all of the interview clips at once. And better yet, you can use those fully transcribed timelines to edit directly from one timeline to the other. Use Tab to go to your creative sequence and then Append. Oh, and the big kicker is we can actually pull out our speed editors again and have fun selecting the text with the search style. So you're probably wondering, why would I edit from timeline to timeline when I could just go from clip to timeline? Wouldn't that be faster? Well, maybe, but you actually have a lot more creative control if you put all of your clips on a timeline that can be trimmed, it can be marked, you can look at your markers in the marker index and export those as a spreadsheet file. You might not have known that, but it just gives you a lot more control to go from a ton of footage down to a smaller subset and to your final cut, and then still be able to reference back to other alternate takes that may have happened along the way. The typical workflow I've done for many years is you put markers on clips on the timeline, just like this.
You create somewhat of a bond with, the friends we make along the way.
Friends we make along the way. You get the idea. Basically, what I did here to jump between all these markers is I've actually typed in every word that's said so I can quickly find and search them in the edit index, or also the marker index is another new, really cool way to see those lines of text. But we don't need this anymore. So I'm gonna close the index over here and I'm gonna go to our clips and create a quick string out. The best way to do this is to double click the clip name header so that sorts them all in case they got out of order. Make sure there's no in and out marks on any of those clips, okay? And then you can just select them all. I'm gonna use a shift click to select them, right click, say create a new timeline using selected clips, and we'll just call this one transcribe me, okay? Something like that. And you can see we have all the clips in a row from that sequence, all right? Now to transcribe them, it's super, super simple. So if you right-click any individual clip, you could go down here to transcribe audio and it'll transcribe it. But another way you can start to automatically transcribe is to select the timeline and then go use this special new button. So we're just gonna give this a click and let the computer do all the work. And it's done, just like that. We have a transcription window that's brand new in Resolve 18.5. And what this has done, it's word for word with the AI gone and transcribed it for us. Now, if it's not white for you, you can click this button right here. I prefer it to be white. And it seems to remember that the next time you go in, you can make the text larger. You can even hit this button right here to export it as a text file, which is great if you want to send that out to a producer. Let's just throw this onto our desktop because that's what you do in tutorials. Then if I go over here to my desktop and open this text file up, you'll see we have a ton of text, okay? So that could be useful. You could throw that in a Google Doc, but I'm gonna close that for now. And we'll go back over here to Resolve. Now, if you close this, it seems like it goes away and it's like, oh no, is that, all that analysis gone? It's not. Even if you save and close the project, it's now stuck with it. You just click the box and then you can click the transcribe button again and all that great metadata is there. The next step is I'm going to show you how to edit timeline to timeline. We need another timeline to do that, right? So what I'm going to do is right click and say timeline, create a new timeline, and we'll call this the selects timeline. Okay, it's just an empty timeline. And what I want to do actually is close all the other timelines over here that are not the selects empty timeline. Now, if you don't see tabs here, you basically don't have stacked timelines turned on. And the way you do that is this button here has this option right here. They call it stacked timelines. It's really tabs. You turn that on and off that way. And we can close the other tabs that we don't want open by just middle mouse clicking is one way that I do that pretty frequently. Okay, middle mouse click, those are all closed. Now, a couple of the shortcuts you wanna probably set up when you're working with tabs and working between different panels in Resolve is if you open up your keyboard shortcuts, keyboard customization, I guess is what they call it, is the tab key I have set to next tab. So that's a really good thing to have. I'm going to close that right now. The other thing you want to probably have available is under your user preferences, and it's called the show focus indicators in the user interface. And what that is, if I hit cancel here, it's this red bar. That's not saying something is unrendered in Resolve. It's basically saying, hey, this has the focus. So if you have focus up here, that's red. But if I want focus down here and I don't know if it is, I can click and we'll see that. Now, I use a shortcut, it's Command 4, to get to the timeline focus. That's going to be part of this workflow to work super, super fast. So command 4 is how I get to that, this panel, this window of the timelines. So that's another thing to know. The other options that you might want to customize or might think about customizing is under timeline, we're going to be using this command called swap timeline and source viewer. Now, by default, it's command page up is the shortcut. I set this to F1 on the keyboard as well, just because it's less buttons to push. So, you know, if that might help you and you're going to do this a lot, F1 is a good option. And the other thing you want to make sure is always turned on is decompose compound clips on edit, which is under the edit menu. And what this menu option does is it makes sure that when you edit from timeline to timeline, it doesn't make a compound nested clip, because you probably don't want that. You want the individual source clip, just because it's just easier to work with, in my opinion. Now, to load this up and create our select sequence, all we're gonna be doing is you take your Transcribe Me sequence and you click and drag. Here's the important part. We don't have it loaded down here in the timeline area at all, okay? It's just the select sequence. We click and drag the Transcribe Me, that's the one that we transcribe, into the left source monitor. As soon as we've done that, we can now hit F1 on the keyboard, and we put it into the source record side swapped, right? But this is different than if we had double clicked it. So that's just important to know. So if I hit F1 again, it goes to the other timeline, F1, we're toggling back and forth. Okay, now you're like, well, what happened to our text? Well, remember, as long as you just hit this transcribe button again, we have all that text metadata, the transcription there available for us. So why don't we just get a piece of text that we like and we can try to cut it in, okay? Why don't we start with this right here where it says, I'm Braxton, okay? Now, I selected this with my mouse. You could use shift arrows to select words. And you'll notice as I'm doing this, over here, this is changing the in and out range of the timeline. So basically we're selecting that range on the timeline versus on the clip itself. Instead of using, you know, the mouse to click and drag, what you can do with the speed editor is mark an in where the cursor is and then use the dial here. It's on scroll, so it's going super fast. If I change it to jog, it won't go as fast word by word, right? And what we can do is scroll to where we want the last word to be. We want it there, hit out. So we have an in and out area marked on our timeline. You can see that over here. Now to get this to our selects timeline, normally you would just hit F9, F10, there's buttons right here to do an insert or an append, but we have an append button on the speed editor. Now, if you hit it right now, it's not gonna work. And that's going back to the focus area that's where we're selected in our project. And we need to focus that red area from up here down to this timeline area. And so the way I'm gonna do that is command 4 to get there, okay? And then from here, we're on the wrong sequence. We're looking at the transcribe me one. We wanna get to selects, and remember to get between the tabs, we push the tab button because we set that in our custom keyboard shortcuts, and now we can hit append. So I'm gonna hit append on the speed editor, and just like that, if I zoom in, you'll see we have that source clip down there. I don't think I have my thumbnails turned on, so you couldn't see that, but it basically took that chunk of text. Let's listen to it.
I'm Braxton Schultz of 704. I almost said 41442
singularity. See, what's cool is it even gets the little things like laughter in the text, which I think is super, super cool. Now, another thing I want to show you is that when you do this swap timeline and source with decomposed compound clips on edit, and I make a selection here of text. Let's say we start with the word these. I hit I, and I go across here. You can see over here on my timeline that I'm gonna actually cross a cut, right? So if that's the case, I'm actually gonna be editing two clips from the source timeline onto my creative timeline or my selects timeline, right? So let's just randomly say we want it to end on the words where it says, that's what I mean. Get to my timeline, remember with command 4, that gets us to the timeline view. I need to get to the right sequence with tab, right? So this is my, you can't see it, but that's my selects timeline. And from there, I just hit append on the speed editor, and let's take a look. Did we get two new clips added? Sure enough, we did. And it's the exact pieces of text that come from this transcript. Now, I don't know of a way to get back to this transcription window over here other than clicking. So I'm a very keyboard-driven editor. I don't like to have to click in too much, you know? So if you find a way, I want to know from you how to do it. So a quick recap, you select the transcription box, you can click and drag it, or you could hit I on the speed editor, and then roll that dial, hit out on the speed editor, and then go to the timeline area with command 4, use tab to go to your creative sequence, and then append. There's these buttons here as well, just to know, and also, I didn't talk about it, but there is a create a subclip button as well. I don't suggest you use this, but it's good to know it's there. How are you going to use this new feature, or what would you like to see them do to it? The old way of working clearly is to use the edit index with markers, and you can just click to any piece, but it's such a manual process. What I would love to see personally is that if I was able to use this Transcribe Me sequence and basically select a piece of text here, hit this marker button, and instead of it just making a marker, a duration marker, which is what it does by default, with no information on it, I would love if it would actually put that piece of text on the name of the marker so that I could go back and use the marker index later on. So if I go to this right here and I hit M, you can see it just named it marker 1. That's not as useful as taking that text and putting it in there. So that's my special request for Blackmagic if you're watching this. I'm Chadwick. This channel is called Creative Video Tips. It's here to help you create videos that make a difference and stand out. But I love teaching all the cool stuff in DaVinci Resolve, especially this new AI stuff. And because there is so much more to learn, I'll see you in that next video.